What it do, YouTube, MJ for Life here. Back again, bringing you some more. Oh, not the deck. YGO, Yu-Gi-Oh! Replay Duels. Watch Replay, that's what I want to go to. And, today we're going to be showcasing my, P-Beetle Turbo deck. So, without further ado, let's just get into it and I'll explain the deck as we go. Well, while we're waiting, I'll just explain. Basically, it's like it sounds. P-Beetle Turbo. The purpose of the deck is to get out P-Beetle and then lock the opponent down using P-Beetle's effect with Save Zone and Vanity Emptiness. So it looks like I'm playing up against a Synchron, a junk Synchro player who has Obelisk randomly thrown in there, which isn't the worst idea just because, you know, you can spam a bunch of monsters in that deck, so, you know, getting 3 monsters for Obelisk isn't that hard. But he obviously doesn't have that great of a hand, so I'm just going to P-Beetle. Target one of my back rows. I can't remember which one I targeted. I think it was Save Zone, yeah. So I'm going to P-Beetle target a Save Zone, so he's going to stay back in one of my back rows. It's a breakthrough skill. I'm here, I'm just going to chain the Thunderbird to his 1-for-1. Just going to get that Thunderbird off the field just in case, you know, he wants to do some shenanigans. And now he's just going off. I could have breakthrough skilled the junk Synchron, but I felt like it wasn't really worth it because he was going to be able to Synchro with it either way, so I didn't really feel like it was that big of a deal. And I wasn't threatened because I have P-Beetle plus Save Zone. Plus, I have the option to make any rank 4 I want on my next turn. So he's actually going to draw into a Space Typhoon off of the Tuning Word draw, which is the hilarious. So now he's going to go for Junk Berserker, I believe that is. Yep, Junk Berserker, and then he's going to attempt to attack over my P-Beetle, but I do have the Save Zone, as I said. So I'm going to, during the standby phase, the Thunderbird returns to the field. Normal Sun Magidora attempt to attack over the Berserker, but for some reason, YGO Pro just wouldn't let me activate the Gaga Cowboy's effect, so I'm forced to just crash into Stardust and end. Fortunately for me, well, I don't know why I couldn't say that, he's already used his entire hand, so I'm in a pretty good position here, so I'm just going to add the Thunderbird, and I'm going to Dark Hole, and he's used Key Beetle's effects to protect itself, and then attack the game. And he realizes the game is over, so he's going to scoop before I can actually finish the game off. So that's the first game. We'll get into the second game, which is going to be against Ice Barriers. Yeah, that's a terrible deck. But Ice Barriers, actually, if they get all their pieces on the field, like all the specials, like Ice Barrier, Rock Card, then they're actually tough to deal with. But, I mean, how often is that going to happen, honestly? So he goes for the standard Ice Barrier play, Medallion of the Strategies. Pitch one, draw one, standard stuff. I'm going to go for my first turn. That's a Key Beetle, and my hand is broken because I have both Save Zone and Vanity's Emptiness on my field. Now, he later revealed that face down card was a Mirror Force, and I'm not really sure why he didn't activate it. I mean, he didn't know that I had a Lance in my hand, so there's really no reason for him to activate it. I'm not really sure why he didn't. I guess he figured that since I was going to, I already activated the effect to protect my card, that there was really no point in Mirror Forcing it, but now he chooses to activate it. And I could activate Save Zone, but I feel like Lance is better because if I can prevent from not being able to attack directly, I would like to do so. So I'm going to do that instead. And looking at his hand, he can't do anything. He's going to normal summon the prior. I don't know why he did that. He's going to scoop next turn as I attack over his prior and then end my turn. And, I mean, he can't do anything. I don't even think there was anything that he could have possibly drawn into that would have helped him in this situation since he already used Mirror Force. I mean, maybe Dark Hole, but nah, I don't think so because I could just use P-Beetle's effect. So that was the game. Pretty much smashed Ice Bears. If they can't special summon, they can't do anything. Now we're going to go up against Heraldix once again. A lot of people like Heraldix on Death Pro, I don't know, or YGO Pro for whatever reason. So he's going to go for the set the Sand Gem Knight. Once again, Heraldix playing Sand Gem. It's a pretty good little slow card. I don't really like it, but then who am I to talk? I mean, I'm playing Spy and Mystic Tomatoes, and those cards are super slow as well. But here he goes for Photon Path. Now he should have actually used the Amber Conway to make it instead of the Leo because he just missed out on the Leo effect. And he just basically wasted 2,000 attacker for no reason. But I'm gonna activate Spy's effect since Photon Path does not prevent fifth summons from happening. And I'm just gonna go off here, make a Key Beetle, and just randomly target the Spy because I figured, hey, if he has Dark Hole, I can save protect my Key Beetle and not have to waste my Lance. So he's gonna go for the Medallion, a high Medallion. All right, so I'm gonna chain Max C to that, so that's gonna give me at least 2 draws. And luckily I've drawn to the Veiler as he goes for the Genome Heritage, so I can Veiler that, an amazing top deck on my part. I can Veiler the Genome Heritage, then force him to attack over my Spy. Now I'm going to draw into a Breakthrough Skill. I'm going to Normal Summon the Thunderbird, and then I'm going to attack over the Genome Heritage. Then I'm going to attack with Amber Conway with the Thunderbird and Lancet, because I don't want to give him the ability to go for, you know, to spam the field with Link 4, since I know he has at least one Heraldic Beast Eel in his hand, and I just didn't want him to, you know, spam the field with all the nonsense. So that's what he's going to try to do here, go for Goblin Bird, but again, I do have some extra protection with the Breakthrough Skill, so I'm going to Breakthrough Skill the Goblin Bird. Again, I targeted my Breakthrough Skill, didn't really have to, but just in case he had Dark Hole, I wanted to protect my field. So now I'm going to attack over the Goblin Bird and then attack the 2500. And then end the game, and I banished Thunderbird last turn because I figured that the only thing in Heraldus that can actually attack over Thunderbird is Heraldic Beast of Leo, and he's already used two, so I figured that I have high chances that he won't be able to attack over my Thunderbird. And then he goes for Sand Gem and sends his last Heraldic Beast Leo, so I no longer have to worry about that. And now he's going to attempt to go for the Reborn Heraldry, but I do have the Vanity's Emptiness. So at this point, it's pretty much a good game, because even if I know he has a Basilisk, which is why I'm not going to attack his face down with my Key Beetle, and then I'm just going to attack the Key Beetle for game. So good game for all the player, as we're going to go into the next duel, which is against Battling Boxer. So I believe my opponent went first. Nope, I go first this time. And no, this is where I make a freaking stupid play. So I go for Duality, going to take the Vanity's Emptiness. I'm like, oh, now I can go for Key Beetle for the Vanity's and Save Zone. So my plan was to Normal Summon and Special Summon Kage Tokage. You can already see how retarded that is, because I activated Duality, so I can't Special Summon. So I kind of just left my Mandragora out to dry. But it's okay, because I'm going to Normal Summon my Spy. I have the Lance to protect my Key Beetle, just in case he wants to Bottomless me or something like that. So now I'm going to go for my the Dispatch's favorite play, which is Key Beetle set Vanities and Save Zone, and then protect the Vanities. Now he's going to Dark Hold me here. Again, I'm in a position where I could Save Zone, but there's really no reason not to. So now he's going to attempt to activate the Switch Hitters effect. I'm going to Vanities that. He's going to set an attack, and I know the only reason why he would attack me is if he has the Counter Blow in hand, which as you can see he does. So I'm going to Save Zone it to prevent. Now he could waste the Counter Blow to save his monster, but he decided not to do that. And I'm going to use Key Beetle's effect to target Save Zones, and now I'm protected. I can protect my Key Beetle, but he's already used Dark Hole, so I'm not really worried about that. I'm going to go for Duality, hope to draw into a Thunderbird. I do, because he has some back row, and I want to be able to attack him directly. And Thunderbird will basically bait out any of his back row, because if it's a Mirror Force, Deep Prison, Torrential, anything like that, Thunderbird can just activate its effect to prevent those cards from actually being affected. So I'm going to attack over his face down, which is the Veiler, and you know if they're setting Veiler, they don't have anything. Set the Book of Moon just as a, you know, an extra precaution if he wants to summon something. So he's going to set the Max C now, and once again, once I saw that he set a Veiler, I knew he had nothing. And when you're setting Max C, you don't have anything. So we're going to attack once again, end my turn. And he's going to draw into a Duality this time. Hope to Duality into something good. I'm going to chain Thunderbird's effect, get him out of there, just in case if he drew into a Reveal the Glass Jaw like he did, that he wouldn't be able to attack over my Thunderbird, so I can continue to attack him directly. And so now I'm going to Book of Moon the headgear, because I know he basically wants to just counter blow me, since I know he has one in hand, since he attacked me with the Split Shredder before, and I know he just sent one in the grave. So I'm going to Normal Summon Max C to go for game. Why not? And it turns out that his back row was nothing. It was a Bottomless and an Xyz block. He set the Bottomless after I went for Key Beetle. And at that point, since I did have the Thunderbird, Bottomless was actually useless at that point. So good game. And now we're going to go up against the Light Swarm player. He's playing some of the new Light Swarm cards, as well as some other Chaos Dragon. I mean, he's playing a lot of cards. But then again, Light Swarm, you can play a lot of cards because you know so much. So I'm going to go for the first turn Key Beetle. And I believe that was a Vanities. Yep, first turn Key Beetle for Vanities and Forbidden Lance. Just so good. He's going to go for that card. What is it called? Minerva or something? Yeah, Minerva. Then he's going to mill a Wolf. I could have activated Vanities there, but I didn't really feel like it was necessary. So we'll Normal Summon the Mystic Tomato and attack. Basically, another reason why I wanted to do that is because I was hoping to draw into another level 4, because two Key Beetles protecting each other is just too good. Now, he top decks into a Chaos Sorcerer, which normally would be bad for me, but I have the Veiler, so it's not even a big deal. And here I'm just hoping I can go to draw into a level 4. I do draw into a level 4, however, it is Kage Tokage, and you cannot Normal Summon Kage Tokage, unfortunately, so I'm not able to get the double Key Beetle. And I know Light Swarm can Special Summon at any time. He only has two in his graveyard, so I don't have to worry about a Dragon. He top decks into a Lumina. He's going to go for Dark Hole. Once again, Gonna save my key beetle with the Forbidden Lance. Now he's gonna go for the Lumina, pitch a Gyarados, try to stuff some Gyarados, but no. And now I'm forced to activate my Advantage Emptiness here. Didn't really want to do that, as I said before. I wanted to go for two key beetles, because it's just so much more secure. And here I'm gonna normal summon the Tomato. Don't want to attack the Lumina with my key beetle just in case he had Honest, so that was really good that I drew into another Tomato just to bait out the Honest. And he draws into a Delta Flyer, which is really interesting. I guess maybe he wants to go for some like Star Eater plays, perhaps. But now I'm just going to normal summon the Thunderbird, activate Key Beetle's effect on the Mystic Tomato, just in case it's a Raikou, so that way he won't be able to Raikou and pop my Key Beetle, and then attack again. So that was that game, and now we'll get into the last duel, which is against Constellers. So probably going to be a very good deck this meta game, so let's see how Key Beetle Turbo works against Constellers. Now, as you can see, my hand is crap, so if he had a normal hand, he would have, I mean, the game would have been over, but luckily for me, his hand was not the greatest either, so he's going to Duality. That tells me that he doesn't really have anything. He's going to take the Dark Hole and set some stuff. I'm going to Night Beam his, or Space Typhoon his back row, actually, and then I'm going to flip up the Spy. It turns out to be a save zone, which you don't really expect in Constellers. I've never seen that. So now I'm going to attack over the Key Beetle. I was like, please don't have Honest. But it turns out that he has Honest. So I'm forced to get rid of my own save zone. So we traded save zones there. So now he's going to Duality once again. So I don't have to worry about a Pleiades or anything like that. But I do have the Veiler, so I'm not really worried. Now he's going to attack, attempt to Book of Moon me. But I'm going to Book of Moon his card as well. So now you're not going to attack over me. Now I also force him to use the Dark Hole here. So that's really good here. So we're both playing a clear field. But I top deck into a Veiler. Not a very good top deck for me. So I'm forced to pass. Now he's going to special summon his Photon Thrasher, normal summon the Sunbreak, then overlay for Utopia just to stall a little bit more because obviously you can see his hand, all he has is a Space Typhoon. So he's going to set that and then end his turn. Now what I'm going to do here is I don't want to take any chances because I drew it for Breakthrough Skill, so I'm saying, you know what, it's time to play the top deck game because I can't really do much. So I'm going to set the Breakthrough Skill really good against his deck because it prevents like the Algae, it prevents the cost, and plus I have Breakthrough Skill plus triple Veiler, so I'm not worried about nothing. I was kind of worried about Gores here, but I figured I just gotta go for it because I don't really have any other choices. Yeah, running into Gores would have been bad there, but I mean, Mr. Tomato can protect me because of its effects, especially some more when it's sent to the graveyard. So I felt like in the end it was better to attack. So I'm gonna attack again on my next turn, drawn to a Kage to Kage again in this situation. When you're top decking, Kage to Kage is really one of the worst cards to top deck because you can't normal summon it, which I feel like I hate that you can't normal summon it. So now he's going to draw into a Sheridan, attempt to get his deck going by adding cards, and I'm just going to say no to that nonsense, forcing him to end his turn. Now my turn, I get Advantage Emptiness, which is a perfect card against Constellers, so I'm going to attack over Sheridan, but I'm not going to set the Vanities because I want to wait for my Key Beetle so that I can protect it. I have a Breakthrough Skill plus a Veiler, so I'm not worried about anything that he can go for. So he's going to attempt to go for Algae and special summon the cost, but I'm going to Breakthrough Skill that, and he's not even going to attack the enemy, which is fine by me. So I'm going to normal summon the Thunderbird, special summon Kage to Kage to Kage. Wow, I cannot talk today. And then again, I didn't want him to have Gore, so that's why I didn't attack. And what I do here is I'm going to actually keep his effect and then chain the Thunderbird because I know that Constellers can't do anything to get over a 1950 attacker, so their strongest monster I believe is 1800, which is cost. Costs, and he said Veiler, so that tells me that he doesn't have anything, so I'm going to attack with the Key Beetle directly. I think that his face down is a compulse, and I'm going to normal summon the Sombre, activate the effect. I didn't want to activate the Vanities because I wanted it to be a surprise, and I wanted to wait for him to actually get that use effect to get that extra normal summon and then activate it, but he decided not to do that. Now he's going to compulse my Thunderbird to prevent himself from losing this turn, and he's basically trying to give himself another turn. So now he's going to normal summon Algae, attempt a special summon cost, but nope, going to chain that Vanity of Emptiness, and then he sets the Mirror Force. So basically his plan was to go for Pleiades and then set Mirror Force, and just be pretty much good to go from there, but nope, it doesn't turn out to end that way because I have the Lance, so he's going to try to Mirror Force me. I'm going to Lance my Key Beetle, activate the Thunderbird's effect, and then next turn he draws into a Sheridan, I believe, which definitely can't help him. At that point, I mean, there's nothing you can really do to top deck to get over Vanity's Emptiness. So that's the game, and those are the duels showcasing the deck. So now we'll get into the deck profile. So first card we have here is Dark Arm, triple Evil Swarm Thunderbird, triple Evil Swarm Mandragora, triple Mystic Tomato, triple Gatekeeper Spy, triple Kaiser Kagage, two Summoner Monk, two Max C, two Baylor, one Dark Hole, two Nightbeam, two Duality, two Space Typhoon, one Book of Moon, two Forbidden Lance, two Deadly Skill, triple Vanity Emptiness, triple Save Zone, extra deck, got this, you know, mouth over the stuff so you can see it. You know, just some standard rank 4 stuff. Alright, so now, first card is Dark Iron Dragon. Really thinking about taking this out because it's almost like we run too many dogs for Dark Iron. I might take this out for an Allure of Darkness or maybe even a BLS because we have two Veiler, plus the ability to make any rank 4 that we want, and we have two light level 4 rank 4 that we can go for whenever we want to. So yeah, I might just take this out and put either Allure of Darkness or BLS in here, meaning more towards Allure of Darkness. Triple Evil Smoke Thunderbird, this is a really good first turn card. It has a really great effect that prevents it from, you know, being hit by traps, basically, or anything, really. And it also gets the extra 300 attack. I mean, this card is just too good, in my opinion. Not as good as Wind Up Rabbit because it can't basically activate its effect at any time, but this card is a much more powerful attacker than Wind Up Rabbit, so I think it's a fair trade-off, but really good card, Evil Swarm Thunderbird. Evil Swarm Mandragora, a great thing about it is you can normal summon or special summon. This card is good on your first turn, or if you're going first or you're going second, so that's why Evil Swarm Mandragora is good. Mr. Tomato, just one of a bit slower card, but that's why we run two Veiler plus two Breakthrough Skill to protect this card because it's a little bit slower. But this can go, but this gets you basically either the Dead Keeper Spy, or you can go to another Tomato, or you can go into Summoner Monk, just depending on the situation. Dirty Spy, again, a bit slower card, but that 2,000 defense is really, really good. It's hard to get over that with just a normal, with just one summon. Kage Tokage, again, really helps you go for rank 4 XYZs. It has the downside that you can't normal summon it, so a lot of times it is going to be a dead top deck if you ever get to that point. So I don't know. I mean, it really does work. I mean, it's good, but it's also bad. So it's, you know, it has its pros and cons. And Summoner Monk is another good card. You know, you play a bunch of spells. You know, the best thing to do is Summoner Monk pitch Duality since you can't use it anyway, and then, you know, go from there. But Summoner Monk, another really good card. And it's also, you can special summon it with Tomato, so that's really good. Two Maxi, two Veiler, just standard hand traps. Veiler alongside Breakthrough Skill really help protect your slower cards, being the Grave Keeper Spy and the Mystic Tomato, as I already said. Dark Hold, obvious. Nightbeam, just to hit some of those back rows. Duality, obviously, to draw into the combo pieces that you need. Space Typhoon, same as Nightbeam. Book of Moon, just a really good, amazing channelable card, has so many uses. It's just like, if you have space to put it in your deck, just put it in. It's just too good. Forbidden Lance, a really, really great card. As you see, like, a lot of times people, they'll just straight up Dark Hole your Key Beetle, and this protects it, prevents you from having to use Save Zone, which I like. I might even take out a Night Beam and put another Forbidden Lance in here, because it's just too good. Or maybe just take out the Dark Arm to put a third Forbidden Lance. Either Forbidden Lance or a little Darkness is kind of what I'm leaning towards now, but Forbidden Lance is just so good in this deck, especially alongside Key Beetle, because you think, you know, if they get something like a Strap Dragon out and they attempt to attack over you, you can just Lance it in the damage step. Lance has so many, just has such utility, sort of like Book of Moon. Like, you two cards have really great utility. I've kind of already explained the Breakthrough Skill. Vanity Emptiness and Save Zone are like the main key cards that go alongside your Key Beetle. Key Beetle plus this card, it's really hard to stop because, you know, Key Beetle's gonna protect this, so they can't Space Typhoon it. And it's also, Key Beetle also allows you to use other cards alongside the Vanity Emptiness without having to worry about it going for the graveyard via its secondary effect. And then Save Zone basically just prevents your Key Beetle from being targeted or destroyed. Can't attack directly, but Key Beetle, Save Zone, Key Beetle, but this plus Evil Swarm Thunderbird, it's just too good. I mean, it's just too good. And the great thing about Evil Swarm Thunderbird is that you can use it alongside Vanity Emptiness because Thunderbird does not special summon itself back to the field, it just returns to the field. So that's one thing to note that's really, really big. So that's the deck for you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. As always, don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe, and I'm out of here. Thank you.